Welcome to the online training for the Karner Blue Butterfly Volunteer Monitoring Program. This training is meant for new volunteers or for current volunteers who would like a refresher. This training is broken into two parts, the introduction and identification section, and the survey and data submission method section. Please be sure to take the quiz after you've watched both videos. Here we will start with the introduction and identification. The Karner blue butterfly was listed as federally endangered in 1992. Then in 1999, the Wisconsin Habitat Conservation Plan was implemented. The goal of this plan was to conserve Karner blue butterflies while allowing activities to occur that could impact Karner blues or their habitat. Then in 2003, the Federal Recovery Plan was implemented. This is the plan where Fish and Wildlife Service set goals for reclassification and delisting of Karners. The national range for the Karner blue butterfly extends from Wisconsin eastward. Its current range is significantly smaller than its historical range, and Wisconsin has the most amount of Karners in its entire range. In Wisconsin, we have what's called a high potential range map. This is a model that was created to predict the highest likelihood of where Karners would be found in the state. Karners can be found in a variety of habitats on the landscape, including savannas, barrens, prairies, and right-of-way corridors. The Karner blue's only host plant is wild lupin. This means that the Karner larva can only eat this one plant. Wild lupin comes from the pea family and typically grows in clumps. The leaves have 7 to 11 leaflets and is found growing in sandy soils. This plant blooms from May to June, and colors can be found in a range of white to purplish blue. Next, we will look at the life cycle of the Karner blue. First, we will look at the egg form. Karners overwinter as eggs, meaning they spend their time in this life cycle during the winter months. Then, typically in April, larvae hatch from these eggs and begin eating lupin. Ants tend to these larvae during these months and form a mutualism. Larvae secrete a sugary substance that the ants eat and in turn provide protection to the larvae. After the larvae go through their instar stages, the adult butterflies hatch. The adults will hatch their first flight during late May to early June. Then, they will lay their eggs, and adults typically live for approximately 7 days. Then the second flight will begin in early to mid-July with the second flight adults hatching, and they will lay their eggs, and those are the eggs that will spend the winter months and hatch the following year. Here is a video example of the ants tending to a larva. Here is a visual representation of the Karner life cycle. At the beginning of the year into early April, Karners are in their egg form. Then they will hatch into their larval state and eat lupin. Then they will pupate and hatch into adult butterflies in late May, early June. Then those adults will lay eggs and the process will continue again into the second flight adults in mid-July. Once those adults lay their eggs, those are the eggs that will spend their time over winter and hatch the following year. Now let's talk a little bit about anatomy and terminology. When you are looking down at a butterfly with its wings open, you're looking at the top side of the butterfly. When the butterfly has its wings closed, that's called the underside of the butterfly. These terms are very important in helping differentiate when you're talking about identification markings. Now, if we look at the difference between the two sets of wings that butterflies have, the wings at the top are called the forewings because they're towards the front of the butterfly, and the wings that are towards the back of the butterfly are called the hind wings. Now let's talk about how to identify a Karner blue compared to other butterflies. The main way to identify if a blue is a Karner blue is the band of orange crescents on both the forewing and hind wings on the underside of the butterfly. Karners also have metallic blue dots adjacent to those orange arcs on their hind wing. The size of the Karner blue butterfly is relatively small. They're about the size of a postage stamp or thumbnail. Wing shape is another important way to identify if you're looking at a Karner blue. Here you can see hair streaks on the left may look slightly similar to a Karner blue, but when you compare the wing shape, you can see that Karner blues have more lobed portions to their wings and they're not as straight as compared to the hair streaks. In order to identify the gender of a Karner, you have to look at the top side. If we look at the top side of the butterfly on the left, it is a bright blue color with no other discernible markings. This can be identified as a male. The butterfly on the right has a more dullish brown color and has orange arcs on her hind wings. That's how you can tell that that's a female Karner. When trying to identify Karners, it's important to know that there are other blue species out there as well as hair streak species that you may get confused or think are Karners. So it's important to remember these identifying characteristics that we're discussing here today. One of the most common lookalikes that you will probably run into is the eastern-tailed blue. This can be identified as not a Karner because it does have tails on its hind wings and it only has two orange arcs on the underside of its hind wings, as compared to Karners who do not have tails and have orange arcs on both the hind wing and the forewing. Another lookalike you might run into is the silvery blue. This is easy to identify as not a Karner because when you look at the underside, there are no orange arcs. You will likely run into a lot of spring and summer azures, but when you look at the underside, you can see that there is no orange, so this cannot be mistaken for a Karner either. The northern blue butterfly looks very similar to Karners, but their ranges do not overlap, and unfortunately, it is believed that this butterfly has been extirpated from the state. The coral hair streak does look somewhat similar to Karners, but they do not have the metallic blue dots on the hindwing, and their wing shape is very different than Karners. They are also typically larger than Karners. Now let's test ourselves and see if we can identify a Karner. Do you think that this is a Karner? Yes, it is. We can very clearly see that there are orange arcs on both the hindwing and the forewing on the underside of this butterfly. How about this? Do you think this is a Karner? This is not a Karner because it clearly has tails on its hindwing
and it only has two orange arcs on the hind wing of the butterfly. How about this? Is this a Karner? This is definitely not a Karner, though it does have some orange arc looking identification marks on that hind wing. We can see that the wing shape is very different and there are no metallic dots on the hind wing either. How about this? Are these Karners? Yes, if we look at each butterfly individually, we can clearly see the orange arcs and the blue metallic dots on the hind wing, as well as orange arcs on the forewing of all three of these butterflies. What do you think of these two? Are these Karners? It might be tempting to say that the butterfly on the left is a Karner, but technically we don't know because we cannot see the underside of this butterfly. But the butterfly on the right is a Karner. We can see the orange arcs on both the forewing and the hindwing. Do you think this is a Karner? Definitely not. This should be easy to say, this is not a Karner. How about this? After looking closely, you can see that the orange arcs are showing up on the forewing and the hindwing on the underside of this butterfly. How about this? Is this a Karner? The correct answer is we don't know because, again, we cannot see the underside, so it could be another blue species. Is this a Karner? Definitely not. We can see tails on this butterfly as well as no orange arcs on that forewing. That's it. Now you can identify a Karner blue. Please be sure to watch the survey and data submission methods video next to learn how to contribute valuable data. Thank you.